Get ready to match the stars. Donald Ross, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Isabel Sanford, Richard Dawson, and Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rutter.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Now what? What? What's so funny? What did I miss?
I told her that I had a great opening joke. And it was deadly silence.
Oh. He's going to work alone.
He's going to what?
Work alone. Do you want to try it again? We'll give you another chance.
See, the joke is as you go.
Hark, what was that?
The guy said, I don't hear anything. The other guy said, I know, it's been like that all day.
What? Do you remember about the camel and the needle and the whole thing that I did once?
And it didn't
same
work.
Thing.
Same thing. Okay. Now let's say hello to our two players, Beth Marie and Richard Prince. How are you? This lady has won $350, right? And she's a 21-year-old graduate student. You go to school around in this area somewhere?
Pepperdine, Malibu.
Pepperdine, Malibu. And you're an aspiring actress?
Yes.
And have you been trained as an actress?
I've been studying for about 4 years.
Oh, you have? Yes. Well, you're a very pretty girl, and you ought to have some degree of success in that. She's being challenged by Richard Prince. We're in the middle of round two, Richard. And you've had both of your questions. You've matched two of our celebrities. At this moment, she has one. But when we come back from this commercial, she'll have her question. All she has to do is match one to tie, two to win. Tune in 1 minute and 5 seconds and see how this turns out.
I give you the wolf.
Yes. Oh, hello there. How are you? We've been waiting for you, haven't we?
Yes.
I'm all mixed up here. Now,
that?
Beth, if you're ready, there's your question. This is the last question in this game, unless it ends up in a tie. Jack said...
Wait a minute. There's one person here who does not write.
And that's you.
This very rarely happens.
Yeah.
So I feel I would like to make a public announcement about...
Beth does not play because she matched in the first round.
Yay!
Yesterday.
Because of her attitude, yes.
Right. Sometimes she doesn't play when she writes on the card.
Anyway, this fellow Jack said, I think that guy standing on the window ledge just wants attention. When the crowd gathered, he didn't jump. Instead, he dropped his blank. Okay. What else?
Now, who is answering this? I must know that.
Everybody except Brett.
No,
Beth plays there.
Uh-huh.
Jackson,
okay.
I think that guy standing in the window ledge just wants attention. When the crowd gathered, he didn't jump. Instead, he dropped his blank. Now, as soon as Charles is ready, we'll be on our way.
He's drawing a picture.
Oh, he is. Oh,
we don't know what it is.
Is crystallized in his mind, and we can press on.
Does Beth Marie need a lift to school in the morning?
Now, there'd be none of that until after... None of that now in front of me. Remember, I'm an older man. Jack said, I think that guy standing on the window ledge just wants attention. When the crowd gathered, he didn't jump. Instead, he dropped his...
Pants.
Sharon, these people are yeeing a flasher.
Or flashing a yeer, as this case may be.
What do you say?
A trashy group.
Yes.
Beth Marie,
right.
Would you trade a lift for a pair of pants? Well, you got one.
There's one for Beth. That's still tied right now. Give her the pants. So you don't play. And Charles, it's up to you. She's looking for a pair of pants.
The suit comes with two pairs.
So that means she wins again. What do you have? Richard, it was a pleasure meeting you. You know, you look a little too young to be in retirement. And you have no gray hairs or anything like that. We've got some gifts for you, which we hope you will enjoy.
Thank you.
And we wish you the best of luck. Richard Prince, ladies and gentlemen.
Bye, Richard.
done this before.
You know how it goes, so we'll just go on and see how much more money you could win. You could win over $5,000 here. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Latin blank. Now, the answer that bunch gave most frequently is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the answer they gave second most frequently, you get $250, and then the third gets you $100. Now, three of our celebrities are permitted to suggest some answers here to you, and you should try and think of some, too.
Charles?
My new show on CBS, which begins January 12th at 8:30, Latin Lover.
Latin Lover's one.
Richard,
Latin...
Pardon?
Latin blank is what we're after.
Very
here.
Good, thank you. Anything else?
No, that's as far as we can go with it. Latin blank.
Well, yeah. Oh, just a second. Yeah. I'll do this. Latin quarter.
Latin quarter. Oh. Okay, yeah. That's two.
Correct.
Brett, have you got one? I know third is a tough position.
Latin. Latin half. I love it. Latin half dollar.
Latin.
He's always such
well,
a
Latin
help,
quarter
but you're
work,
in.
Maybe
Latin half dollar might work too.
Okay, now this is number three, but it's going to be the best one. Now, prepare yourselves for hurrah. Latin class!
What a good dead language.
Latin class. Okay, there they are. Latin class, Latin lover, and Latin quarter. Do any of those appeal to you?
Latin lover.
Latin lover appeals to you? She says she likes Latin lovers. I could let my sideburns grow and grow a little tricky mustache here and speak with an accent. Okay. Latin lover is what she wants. Here, let's find her a Latin lover, shall we? Latin lover, are you hiding under the $100 response? No. Wow. Latin quarter is there, though.
Boy, has that gone up.
Yes, yeah.
It's $100.
Oh, yeah.
Let's find out if we got a Latin lover under the $250 number.
Latin America.
Latin America is a very good one.
I was a little late.
Yeah.
I'm a slow thinker.
5 minutes late. All right, last chance, you rascal Latin lover. Let's find out if you're hiding under the $500 number.
Yeah.
Yes, indeed. Congratulations. Can't play from there. No, it's not allowed because she could see.
I get to play with you and that's okay with us.
No, because I'm the star of the show. Get your own show, Donald. That's the way it goes. Okay. Now, listen, you've just picked up an additional $500. That means at this moment, the cash accrued to your account is $950. Now, you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or 5,000. To collect that amount of money, you've got to match one celebrity exactly.
Richard.
Okay, Richard. Get ready. I guess you can stand on the adhesive tape if you want. And okay. And here we go. This one's worth $5,000. And it goes like this. Bald blank. That's B-A-L-D. Bald blank. Finished. Okay, Beth, here we go again. It's up to you to give us an answer which you think will match Richard's. Now, remember, the idea is for you to get your ESP going over to him. Bald blank.
Eagle.
Bald eagle.
Wait
a minute. What are you saying?
I was going to say that or head.
Either bald eagle or bald head. What made you say bald eagle?
I don't know. I thought of bald head first, but then bald eagle sounded...
sounded better. Okay, well, they're both good answers, and I'm sure Richard must have one of them, and I hope he's got the one you've got.
I never hesitated. That's exactly what you had.
Oh, I was going to go with my first thing.
You didn't do that.
You know, then later I said eagle, but I always go on that.
Was
that the first thing you thought of?
Yes.
Was it?
Yes,
yeah.
Bald head, and then I...
Yeah, this is a game where you have to trust your first instinct here, and it usually works, not always, but most of the time.
That's
Donald,
the rule,
you have bald eagle?
Yeah. Trust your first instinct, but not the MC, isn't that? I mean,
that's it.
In the
that's
the
way it goes.
Yes.
Okay, Beth Marie, you've got your 950, and you're going to meet another player in a moment or so after we do a little business with America. Boy, here we go. Are you ready to welcome another player?
Yeah.
Would you all give a good, brisk round of applause to Carol Bittick? Hello, Carol. Hi. Now let's find out a little bit about Carol, shall we?
I'm a happy housewife. I'm married to an officer in the United States Marine Corps stationed at Cherry Point, North Carolina, and I have three children, and I'm thrilled to be here.
We're thrilled to have you, Carol. Are you vacationing on the West Coast?
No, I came out here just for this, just for you guys.
Okay. Well, we're honored, aren't we honored?
Can I drive her to class in the morning?
What's that?
Can I drive her to class in the morning?
No, you can't drive her to class in the morning there. All right, Carol, we'll begin. We'll begin. Begin.
Begin.
Bong, bong. Yes, Carol, A or B?
A.
A it is. Good luck to both ladies. Here we go. Nanook said. That is. No, he didn't say that.
One of these cold-hearted questions.
Yeah, Nanook said that Eskimo politician will do anything to get a vote. Yesterday, he rubbed noses with my blank. Nanook said that Eskimo politician will do anything to get a vote. Yesterday, he rubbed noses with my blank.
You know what I have to say to that? Anything that gets you through the night.
Right. You got the idea.
How is that Eskimo word? Yesterday he rubbed noses with my.
That's what you're saying.
Have you got the idea now?
Why, hon?
Oh, dear me.
Is it like what we do in Encino in the motel or anything like that, dear?
Get on with it.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, you're just embarrassed because Alan might be watching.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is club soda.
That is.
From Russia.
Okay.
Ready.
Ready.
I got it.
Finally. Now we're coming over here to Carol Biddick and ask her. Nanook said, you know who Nanook is? Oh, well, you watch his program. Certainly you do. That Eskimo politician will do anything to get a vote. Yesterday, he rubbed noses with my...
wife.
Wife. Wife. Wife. Oh. She said wife. That kind of...
Well, we just lost the Eskimo vote.
Yes.
You're taken aback by
it. I'm taken aback by that.
I consider it an affront.
Really?
Yes.
Well, I suppose. Anyway.
Well, so we've covered the front and the back of this question.
All right.
On the other hand, wrong, bottom.
Okay. I don't understand that, but Brett, you're up.
You know, who's he married to? Patty
this
Deutsch?
Patty Deutsch.
I feel sorry for her. I said he rubbed noses with my dog sled.
With a dog sled? You mean a sled dog?
Oh!
You can't rub noses with a sled. You mean a sled dog?
Darn it!
Still doesn't match, no
you
matter
know
how you
the
say
expression.
It.
Drunk again.
What do you say, Charles?
I say people with bad eyes shouldn't try to copy sled dogs.
That Eskimo politician will do anything to get a vote. Yesterday, he rubbed noses with my...
wife.
Wife. Richard?
We feed.
We feed.
Bottom row is the best.
The bottom row is the best so far, yes.
Almost the best. I mean, you know how far away and up north and the long night. You know
nights. Long night.
This may be a match with my walrus.
Walrus. Married to a walrus, was he? Yeah, the bottom row is the best. Two out of three ain't bad. Okay, that's two for you. And now, Beth, here's your first rounder. Hey, listen to this, folks.
Why?
Contrary to popular belief, George Washington not only wore a beautiful, long, powdered wig, he also wore a blank.
George
there
Washington,
it is.
Not only, contrary to popular belief.
Well, if you're going to read it, I gave it to him to read.
Okay.
Contrary to popular belief, George Washington not only wore a beautiful, long, powdered wig, he also wore a blank.
Contrary, it says?
Contrary
to popular belief.
It has nothing to do with it.
Well, you know, most people didn't know this, is what we're saying. Most people didn't know that he not only wore a beautiful, long, powdered wig, he also wore a blank. Okay. Keep your hands off me. He may be watching.
Oh, I thought that was Richard. I'm sorry.
What do you see, Doctor?
Never bother me when I'm in the lab.
I want to take a look. Let me look.
Oh, those little rascals. What are they doing?
Don't
you fool, that's Betty White's leg.
Come on. Listen, while we're waiting for Brett, you're doing a show with Bobby Van. Quiet, I'm talking. You're doing a show with Bobby Van, right?
Yes, the Fun Factory.
And what is that, an hour, half hour?
It's a half hour, and it's on every day, and people should watch. And that's
okay.
Enough of that.
Okay, thank you. Now,
okay.
You ready? Contrary to popular belief, George Washington not only wore a beautiful long powdered wig, he also wore a
pair of pantyhose, stockings.
Pantyhose.
What?
He also wore pantyhose.
What's happened to Beth?
You don't like that answer, pantyhose?
Oh. Wasn't he the mother of our country?
Yeah, no. I mean, if they're good enough for Joe Namath. Why not? What do you say?
You remember what Dickie said?
What?
Do it. Say it again.
He was the mother of our country?
You got it. Dress.
A dress. Okay. Pantyhose is what she's looking for.
He wore...
I hope we have time for this.
A very sweet flowered red skirt with a white fluffy blouse like Betty White wears.
He wore a beautiful long powdered wig, and he also wore pantyhose, according to Beth.
I wanted a masculine answer.
Yes.
Yeah. Let's hear it, Chuck.
So I chose trust.
You watch it.
George, we trust.
And George, we trust, right.
Right. That is
George, we trust. Contrary to popular belief, George Washington not only wore a beautiful long powdered wig, he also wore pantyhose.
Dress.
A dress. Okay.
I knew at night he wore a yellow ribbon.
Yeah.
He looked very attractive.
What did you say?
Dress.
A dress.
Yeah.
Well, really, I don't understand. Do you understand that?
I understand the question.
Yeah.
He not only wore a long, beautiful powdered wig, he also wore a hairpiece.
A hairpiece. Oh. That is the weirdest answer.
You had the
Well, I wouldn't have gone as far as a dress.
What would you have said?
Well,
a bra?
A ruffle? No, not a little ruffles. And well, he did. He did. A girdle, yes.
He did have false teeth.
Yes, he did. Right.
I wouldn't
hair piece isn't bad.
I think dress was definitely.
So here we go.
Contrary.
Well, we're not going anywhere. 2-0 score at this moment, and a round one, round two coming up later, but now this.
I thought dress was on awesome.
Here we go, round two. Now, Carol, A or B?
I'm going to stick with A.
A it is. And two people do not play.
They don't.
Isabel and Richard do not play. The rest of you, please. The passengers on the Titanic couldn't believe it. As soon as they struck the iceberg, the captain jumped onto the ice and started blanking.
No, wait a minute, sweetheart.
Captain of the Atlantic.
A little thing here.
As soon as they struck the iceberg, the captain jumped onto the ice and started blanking. Do it quickly because it's the last question we have time for.
All right. Couldn't believe it. As soon as they struck the ice.
Well, get moving, Charles. We have places to go and stuff to do.
Got it. Got it, baby.
Good. Very good.
Got it.
Yeah. Terrific.
Good.
Okay.
No of you now.
Betty is ready, so we'll call on Carol. Passengers on the Titanic couldn't believe it. As soon as they struck the iceberg, the captain jumped onto the ice and started blanking.
After watching this group, they've got to say tinkling. I know they're going to say that.
Well, on ice? Really? Donald, what'd you say?
Close to tinkling. It's a form of the word whizzing.
Whizzing. Yeah, that's it.
That's one. The same word.
Brett, what have you got?
The good answer away. I thought he was just out there skating.
Very good. That's the answer. Charles?
Skating
is a very good answer. And Betty White?
Well, he liked everything on the rocks. He started pouring. That may be a match.
Started pouring. No. Okay, so that's 3 for Carol. And we're going to have to put you on ice, so to speak, Beth, because now we've got to do a little business with America. Here we go. Next time we get together, these are the bodies that will be on this stage.
Ron Palillo, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Joanne Worley, Richard Dawson, and Fannie Flagg.
Oh, you were splendid. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time for Match Game 76. Goodbye. Stan, these people are yeeing a flasher.
Or flash.
flashing a layer, as this case may be.
What do you say?
A trashy group.
Yes.
Beth Marie.
Beth Marie, right.
Would you trade a lift for a pair of pants? Hmm? Well, you got one.
There's one for Beth. That's still tied right now. Give her the pants. So you don't play. And Charles, it's up to you. She's looking for a pair of pants.
The suit comes with two pairs.
So that means she wins the game. What do you have to do? Richard, it was a pleasure meeting you. You know, you look a little too young to be in retirement. And we, I mean, you have no gray hairs or anything like that. We've got some gifts for you, which we hope you will enjoy.
Thank you.
And we wish you the best of luck. Richard Prince, ladies and gentlemen.
Bye, Richard.
Done this before. You know how it goes, so we'll just go on and see how much more money you could win. You could win over $5,000 here. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Latin blank. Now, the answer that bunch gave most frequently is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the answer they gave second most frequently, you get $250, and then the third gets you $100. Now, three of our celebrities are permitted to suggest some answers here to you, and you should try and think of some, too.
Charles?
My new show on CBS, which begins on January 12th, 8:30, Latin Lover.
Latin Lover's one.
Richard?
Richard, Latin...
Pardon?
Latin blank is what we're after.
Very good, thank you. Anything else?
No, that's... At this moment, she has one. But when we come back from this commercial, she'll have her question. All she has to do is match one to tie, two to win. Tune in 1 minute and 5 seconds and see how this turns out.
So I give you the wool.
Yes. Oh, hello there. How are you? We've been waiting for you, haven't we?
Yes.
I'm all mixed up here. Now, Beth, if you're ready, there's your question. This is the last question in this game. Unless it ends up in a tie. Jack said...
Wait a minute. There's one person here who does not write.
And that's you.
This very rarely happens.
Yeah.
So I feel I would like to make a public announcement about...
Beth does not play because she matched in the first round.
Yay! Thank you.
Because of her attitude, yes. Right.
Sometimes she doesn't play when she writes on the card.
Anyway, this fellow Jack said... I think that guy standing on the window ledge just wants attention. When the crowd gathered, he didn't jump. Instead, he dropped his blank. Okay. What else?
Now, who is answering this? I must know that.
Everybody except Brett.
No,
Beth plays there.
Uh-huh.
Jackson, I think that guy standing on the window ledge just wants attention. When the crowd gathered, he didn't jump. Instead, he dropped his blank. Now... As soon as Charles is ready, we'll be on our way.
He's drawing a picture.
Oh, he is. Oh,
we don't know what it is.
It's crystallized in his mind, and we can press on.
Does Beth Marie need a lift to school in the morning?
Does Beth Marie need a lift to school in the morning? Now, there'd be none of that until after. None of that now in front of me. Remember, I'm an older man. Jack said, I think that guy standing on the window ledge just wants attention. When the crowd gathered, he didn't jump. Instead, he dropped his...
Pants.
As far as we can go with it. Latin blank.
Oh,
just a second. Yeah. I'll do this.
Latin quarter.
Latin quarter. Okay, that's two.
Correct.
Brett, have you got one? I know third is a tough position.
Latin half. I love it. Latin half dollar.
Latin.
He's always such a help.
Latin quarter
work,
maybe.
Latin half dollar might work, too.
Okay. Now, this is number three, but it's going to be the best one. Now, prepare yourselves for hurrah. Latin class.
What a good dead wrong word.
Latin class. Okay, there they are. Latin class, Latin lover, and Latin quarter. Do any of those appeal to you?
Latin lover.
Latin lover appeals to you? She says she likes Latin lovers. I could let my sideburns grow and grow a little tricky mustache here and speak with an accent. Okay. Latin lover is what she wants. Here, let's find her a Latin lover, shall we? Latin lover, are you hiding under the $100 response? No, Latin quarter is there, though.
Boy, is that gone up.
Yes, yeah.
$100.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Let's find out if we got a Latin lover under the $250 number.
Latin America.
Latin America is a very good one.
I was a little late. I'm a slow thinker.
5 minutes late. All right, last chance, you rascal Latin lover. Let's find out if you're hiding under the $500 number.
Yeah!
Yes, indeed. Congratulations. She can't play from there. No, that's not allowed because she could see.
Why did she get to play with you and not play with us?
No, because I'm the star of the show. Get your own show, Donald. That's the way it goes. Okay. Now, listen, you've just picked up an additional $500. That means at this moment, the cash accrued to your account is $950. Now, you're going to play for 10 times there.
Get ready to match the stars. Donald Ross. Brett Summer. Charles Nelson Reilly, Isabel Sanford, Richard Dawson, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Now what? What? What's so funny? What did I miss?
I told her that I had a great opening joke. And it was deadly silence.
Oh.
He's going to work alone.
He's going to what?
Work alone. You want to try it again? We'll give you another chance.
The joke is as you go. Hark, what was that? I said, I don't hear anything. The other guy said, I know it's been like that all day.
What?
Do you remember about the camel and the needle and the whole thing that I did once?
And it didn't
work.
Same thing. Okay. Now let's say hello to our two players, Beth Marie and Richard Prince. How are you? This lady has won $350, right? And she's a 21-year-old graduate student. You go to school around in this area somewhere?
Pepperdine, Malibu.
Pepperdine, Malibu. And you're an aspiring actress?
Yes.
And have you been trained as an actress?
I've been studying for about 4 years.
Oh, you have? Yes. Well, you're a very pretty girl, and you ought to have some degree of success in that. She's being challenged by Richard Prince. We're in the middle of round two, Richard. And you've had both of your questions. You've matched two of our celebrities at $5,000. To collect that amount of money, you've got to match one celebrity exactly.
Richard.
Okay, Richard. Get ready. I guess you can stand on the adhesive tape if you want. Okay. And here we go. This one's worth $5,000, and it goes like this. Bald blank, that's B-A-L-D. Bald blank. Finished. Okay, Beth, here we go again. It's up to you to give us an answer which you think will match Richard's. Now, remember, the idea is for you to get your ESP going over to him. Bald blank.
Eagle.
Bald eagle. Wait a
minute.
What are you saying?
I was going to say that or head.
Either bald head. Eagle or bald head. What made you say bald eagle?
I don't know. I thought of bald head first, but then bald eagle sounded...
Sounded better. Okay, well, they're both good answers, and I'm sure Richard must have one of them, and I hope he's got the one you've got.
I never hesitated. That's exactly what you had.
Oh, I was going to go with my first thing.
You did do that.
She said I said eagle, but I always go on that.
That was the
first thing you thought of?
Yes.
Was it?
Yes, bald head, and then I...
Yeah, this is a game where you have to trust your first instinct here. And it usually works, not always, but most of the time.
That's
Donald,
the rule,
you have bald eagle?
Yeah. Trust your first instinct, but not the MC. Isn't that? I mean, that's
it.
In the
that's
bylaws.
The way it goes.
Yes.
Okay, Beth Marie, you've got your $950, and you're going to meet another player in a moment or so after we do a little business with America. Boy, here we go. Are you ready to welcome another player?
Yeah.
Would you all give a good, brisk round of applause to Carol Bittick?
Hello, Carol.